Welcome to Six Sigma Mania. Six Sigma covers several methods. DMADV, sometimes called DMEDI, helps with developing new, not existing processes. DMADV acronym stands for Define, Measure, Analyze, Design or Develop, Verify or Validate. DMEDI stands for Define, Measure, Explore, Develop, Implement. Five main phases, two different acronyms, but the same method. DMADV acronym is globally more preferred, so I will use it too. As the same as DMIC, DMADV is a set of tools. You can develop any new process, design new feature, product, or build a new service. You do it by exploring each phase, by using tools one by one, in the order I will share in a minute. Each phase is very important to go through and finish it. DMADV should be a team effort. The structure of the project team is the same as on improving projects. There is a project leader, project sponsor, project team, stakeholders, process owner. Each team member has specific and important role. And here is the DMADV tool list. Link to download this template is available under the video, or on my blog sixsigmamania.com. Define project phase is very similar to DMIC tools. It helps project leader, sponsor and team to be aligned with project goal and scope. In Define, we start to think about problem team must address, the concept they have to develop. In the Measure phase, team reveals data about what new design process should deliver. Which are potential customers' expectations and requirements to be met? And what are the main critical parameters new process must have to be working efficiently? Team creates high-level project plan. Analyze phase is there to identify and select the best concept. There can be different solutions, different designs when we develop something new. Only the one of identified solution should be realized. At least to be the first one. Financial requirements and potential investments should be revealed in this phase too. Develop phase serves to detailed concept description and design. Team optimizes its functions to be aligned with real customer requirements from defined phase. There is detailed developing and control plan created. It helps with potential fails prevention. Piloting a new concept can be part of developing phase too. Team can learn real pros and cons and address them prior finalizing whole project. In the verification phase, new design is finished, tested and finally released to the real life. New process performance monitoring is crucial to correct potential failures that were not revealed during analyzing and designing. Monitoring is important to understand if all expected benefits were really reached. There is still space to address minor challenges. Finally, the process is handover to process owner. As stated, not all tools must be used in every DMADV project you run. Stop by each tool when you go through each project phase. Think about how using this particular tool will be beneficial to the project. How this tool can help with reaching the goal and delivering new design. Make sure, when you start, the project team leader is aligned with project sponsor. Charter is properly written. Writing down discussed ideas and requirements to the project charter is important for future project smooth run. Written goal and expectations will avoid potential misunderstandings. And misunderstanding can be from sponsor side, project leader and team side, as well as from stakeholders. Newly designed process owner should be involved in the project from very beginning. I suggest you having her, or him at least as a stakeholder. But the best thing is to be a part of the team, and project sponsor. Future process, or design owner will be responsible for new process sustainability. Detailed understanding how it was developed, and put in place will be good for this person to be satisfied and supporting transition after project finalization. Take a look under the video, where you find a link to my blog, where you can download DMADV tooling list template for your usage. If you find this video helpful, give us a like. We'll be more than happy to have you in our online community, so hit the subscribe button and join Sigma Maniacs. Do not hesitate to post your comments, questions, or themes you are interested in to see on this channel. Looking forward to meeting you with the next video.